गुड आफ्टरनून. ये धुंध के साथ जो आपको फोटोज मिलने वाली और वीडियोज मिलने वाले, इससे 250 एंट्री लाइफ में नहीं हो सकती थी मेरी. मजा आ गया. साथ में हम एंटी पोल्यूशन ड्राइव की भी बात शुरू कर सकते हैं. थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग ऑल ऑफ यू ऑल. थैंक यू फॉर द लवली इंट्रोडक्शन. और आई थिंक गौरव ने वो सारी बातें कर ली है जो मैं भी करना चाहता था. आई थिंक टू एम्फसाइज एंड अंडरलाइन द लव दैट वी आर ऑल शेयरिंग फॉर द स्पोर्ट्स अलॉन्ग विद क्रिकेट दैट आर इवॉल्विंग इन इंडिया. आई फील वेरी वेरी हैप्पी एंड हम्बल टू बी पार्ट ऑफ इट एट सच अ बिग लेवल एंड एट सच अ डे टू डे इंट्रिकेट लेवल. पर सबसे पहले मैं ये कहना चाहूँगा, मेरे 5 साल गुजर चुके इंडस्ट्री में. मेरी शुरुआत आप सबके सामने हुई है. काफ़ी सारे लोग यहाँ पे बैठे हैं जो मुझे शायद थोड़ा पहले से भी जानते हैं. आप सब लोग मेरी तस्वीरें खींचते हो, आप सब लोग बातें करते हो, हम फिल्मों के बारे में मिलते हैं, अलग अलग विषय पे बातें होती. मेरे लिए एट अ वेरी पर्सनल एंड इंटीमेट लेवल एज अ ह्यूमन बींग, एज समबडी हुज हैड एस्पिरेशंस एंड ambitions as a child, as a boy growing up who's had dreams, today is a big realization. Mere liye bahut badi achievement main kahunga hai ki main ek team ka hissa ban paya hu batour owner. Ye jo shabd hai owner, ownership jo hoti hai, kehne ke liye bahut aasan hota hai. It takes you years to reach that level where you can actually feel the ownership of something. And I'm very 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 happy to affiliate with and be part of FC Pune City because they've given me a chance to realize a dream that I've had since I was growing up, to feel like I've achieved and a milestone and a landmark in my career and my life. And I think today is a very important day, and thank you for coming and sharing it with me, and thank you for giving me this opportunity and the platform. Thank you so much for coming here, all of you.
Thank you so much, Arjun. We'd like to just welcome you with a bouquet of flowers and our team scarf of FC Pune City. About your dream coming true, we've captured a few moments of those dreams coming true, and we have a small promo for all of y'all to watch. Can we have the promo, please? That's right, it's time to bleed orange, and I'm sure all of you have a lot of questions to ask Arjun and Mr. Modwell. So we're going to have a small interaction. The floor is now open for any questions that y'all may have. A gentle request to all of you to please restrict your questions only to the occasion today and for the launch event that we have this afternoon. रहने दीजिए गले में.
Hi Arjun, this is Urvi here.
Hi. How are you?
I'm good.
Where are you working now? Firstly.
I'm freelancing for Bollywood Life.
Huh?
Bollywood Life.
Oh, how nice. How are you, Urvi? Happy Diwali to all of y'all.
Belated. Sorry. Arjun, firstly, you've been a huge football fan. What took you so long to associate yourself with the football team?
Aaj Gaurav yaar. Main to taiyar tha. My connect with the FC Pune City has been there since the first season of ISL. Jaise ki aapne kaha, I'm a huge fan of football. I've been for many years. I've followed world football, whether it's European, whether it's South American, all the leagues, and I think I was a very excited person when the league came to India, when we had a proper official league at this level, with the telecast levels and the performances and the stature of players coming in and the infrastructure. It doesn't always mean that you have to jump right in. You have to also wait for the right opportunity, the right fit. Kai bar kya hota hai, aap cheeze kar lete ho hadbadhat mein, but you don't end up finding the connect with the correct people. I'm not somebody who's ever been in a rat race. The excitement has always been to connect with the correct people. I know them from way before, so the comfort level and of course the common thought process takes a few meetings, maybe takes a year to figure out that, okay, we are the right fit. Because I'm in it for the long term, they're in it for the long term, this league is in it for the long term. There is no point jumping the gun and saying, you know, jo mila usse kar lo. It has to make sense for you. They've given me the respect to allow me to be part of the team as an owner where I can be involved in decision making, and that is not something that I take lightly. So I think organically, sahi logo ke saath sahi time pe sahi cheez hone ka bhi ek apna maza hai. And I think I'm also in a place in my life now after now 5.5 years of working, I think I'm in a position where I can expand my horizons. And I would like to pursue my passions in various ways, and this happened at the correct time, I think. We've dabbled on it for quite a few occasions, but it's finally come to fructification now, and I'm very, very happy about it. I think it's the right time for me, and I hope for FC Pune City also.
I also have a question for you, Mr. Gaurav. Ritik Roshan used to be the co-owner for Pune FC. What happened with him? Why is he no longer associated with it?
So Ritik is still the shareholder, but Arjun is now the new face. He's really passionate about football. We've been talking about it as he was speaking. He was with us in the first season. We kept talking about football. Aur, ab maza aayega.
Arjun,
hi. Hi, Seema ji, kaisi hain?
Very well, thank you. If you had to do a biopic on a sports star, who would it be?
Yaar, itni ban rahi hain aajkal, itni ban chuki hain. I would like to do an underdog story. I think those are the most exciting biopics. And yaar, offhand bolna mushkil hai. I hope to we have a footballer coming through the ISL and our teams that I would love to emulate at some point and maybe play a footballing star or a footballing character. I don't know. I mean, MS Dhoni for me is an inspirational name, and they've done justice to Neeraj Pandey, sir, did amazing justice to his story, and we got to see a new side. किसी भी इंसान के बारे में जब आप कहानी बताते हैं उनके अलग पहलू अगर जानने का मौका मिलता है तब कुछ मजा आता है बायोपिक में. तो मैं ज़्यादा करीब से जानता नहीं हूँ इस वक्त और कौन है ऐसा जो एक्साइट करता है. मुझे लगता है युवराज सिंह बहुत ही विचित्र इंसान भी है जो उनकी जर्नी रही है, जिस तरह के उनके उतार चढ़ाव रहे ज़िंदगी के. दादा सौरव गांगुली है, द मैन हु इज़ डिफाइड ऑल. तो ऐसे क्रिकेट में बहुत है. आई थिंक टू आइसोलेट क्या होगा वो हेडलाइन बन जाएगी और फिर वो गलत तरीके से इस्तेमाल की जाएगी. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा कि मैं युवराज की या सौरव गांगुली की करना चाहता हूँ. मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि अगर एक जर्नी होती है तो बायोपिक करने में मज़ा आता है. तो आपके पास कोई होगी तो मुझे प्लीज़ देना, मैं कर लूँगा.
हाय अर्जुन, इलिका here, this side.
Hi Ilika, I still have to reply to your left. I still have to reply to your message. I'm really sorry. My sincere apologies.
That's okay. Okay, we all know you are.
And we will do it.
Okay.
Yes.
So you're promising me in front of
I'm
the cameras now.
I'm promising you live okay. In front of your fraternity friends that the commitment I've made to you shall be fulfilled.
Thank you. We all know you're a Chelsea fan.
Yes.
If a long shot, if you now you're an owner and you are also involved in the decision making and of the players, if you have to get some Chelsea player on board, your favorite, whom would that be?
You know, I would love to get Frank Lampard or John Terry here. I mean, goes without saying, they're iconic names. They've been wonderful servants for Chelsea. They're passionate. They're everything a footballer and a human being should imbibe when it comes to being on the field and off it. Two amazing superstars who've defied a generation and Chelsea Football Club. But like I keep saying, I would like to believe that we will eventually in India also have people like that, that we, our kids and the future generations will look up to. Chelsea is something very close to my heart. I'm a fanboy. I can't even say that I blush when I met them, all of them, I did blush. But I think I would have to say John Terry would be an amazing fit for any football club here. Just, he's a lion-hearted player, and I think he's everything that football stands for. The never-say-die attitude, the sportsman spirit. So he would be an amazing fit.
Also, under 17 FIFA,
yes.
You know, it came to India. And but then, where do you think the main Indian football team lacks, you know, to make a mark in the international circuit?
Yeah, the thing is, now we started a bit late in terms of infrastructure. It's not about the passion. I truly believe today you give a child a football, he'll still start playing on the streets. But there's only so much that can teach you. And in a country where there are a variety of sporting options available, schools don't really indulge in football because the grounds are just huge. You get confined to playing sports that are available within your school and within your growing years. So I feel the formative years for children are important. I feel now you have AstroTurfs available. You see the television boom of having the Premiership, having the Bundesliga, having the La Liga, having all the leagues playing out. Like every night, if I watch TV, I only watch football, honestly. And you can flip channel after channel and you'll get all the football matches happening. We get more football matches in India than they get in England. When I was in England shooting for Mubaraka, they don't actually telecast half the matches live that we do in India. So the connect is huge. The infrastructure has been missing. So we've been lagging behind. I think ISL is the perfect platform. We as a team, FC Pune City, have started out being one of the first teams to actually have infrastructure in place to give youth a chance, to give the women a chance, to give the under-18s, under-16s a chance. So what happens is it allows people to pursue the passion and turn it into a profession and have hope that there is decent pay for it. See, it's very important. At the end of the day, it is a job also for people. When they take up a sport, they have to look at the bigger picture. If you're allowing them a foundation to think that this can be something that they can make their life out of, I think many more people will end up pursuing it and many more parents will indulge their children to go out there and play sports more often. And I think it's a big thing in the last 3-4 years that's happened. There are a lot of sports. I mean, look at Kabaddi. After the video. It's evolved very fast. So I think it comes down to a lot of factors. We are lagging behind because of certain factors, because we've been a cricket-loving nation for many years, which is amazing. But now I feel there's an open-mindedness in the youth to give other sports a chance. And your kids, my kids, they'll all flourish because of that. So, I think it will benefit at some point. And I hope in sooner rather than later.